so many important use cases for deep learning that it's impossible to produce an exhaustive list. Deep learning is just getting started, and new applications pop up all the time. Let's take a look at some of the biggest ones today. At this point, it should be no surprise that machine vision is one of the biggest applications of deep learning. Image search systems use deep learning for image classification and automatic tagging, which allows the images to be accessible through a standard search query. Companies like Facebook use deep nets to scan pictures for faces at many different angles, and then label the face with the proper name. Deep nets are also used to recognize objects within images, which allow for images to be searchable based on the objects within them. Let's look at an example application, Clarify. Let's load Clarify in a browser. Here is the URL, which you'll also find in the video description below. Clarify is an app that uses a convolutional net to recognize things and concepts in a digital image. Let's take a look. Right in the middle of the page, you have the Demo button. Let's click that. It takes you to part of the web page where you have the demo. You have two choices: either choose a URL where the image is located, or load the digital image yourself if you have it on file. I'm going with choice B, loading an image. I'm in the right folder now, and I'm going to select the first one. When I select an image, it wants me to go through a verification process. In this case, it wants me to select all the squares that have a GIF box, so I'm going to go through and do that. This changes every time, by the way. You can have different tests. It's come back and you see the predictions. Firstly, it says there's no person. It expected to find a person, but there weren't any, so it identified that as a pattern for this one, which is cool. The other predictions are tableware, indoors, party, fashion, etc. So this is the list of tags it's associated with this image. If you scroll down, it shows a list of example images and the items in them. Like the first one with a coffee and croissant, which I think is cool. If you go to the one with the concert, it's tagged it pretty accurately with concert, band, singer, etc. You also get similar images. I'm going to pick another one, this time of a county fair. Again, it goes through the same verification process. This time it wants me to pick images with cars. Okay, it came back and gave me some tags. It recognized a Ferris wheel, and though carousel is only partly visible to the left, it still picked it out. It also picked out the word fun. Also, the images it suggested as similar are accurate. They are virtually identical to the one I picked. Further, it presents the same example images as the last time. So there you have it, a demo of object recognition using Clarify. Other uses of deep learning include image and video parsing. Video recognition systems are important tools for driverless cars, remote robots, and theft detection. And while not exactly a part of machine vision, the speech recognition field got a powerful boost from the introduction of deep nets. Deep net parsers can be used to extract relations and facts from text, as well as automatically translate text to other languages. These nets are extremely useful in sentiment analysis applications and can be used as part of movie ratings and new product intros. Here's a quick demo of MetaMind, an RNTN that performs sentiment analysis. Let's load MetaMind in a browser. Here's the URL, which you'll also find in the video description below. MetaMind is an app by Richard Socker that uses an RNTN for Twitter sentiment, amongst other things. You can search by username, or a keyword, or hashtag. I'm going to search by hashtag. My first one's hashtag coffee. When you click classify, it first downloads the tweets, which takes a little time. It then comes back and displays you two things. On the left, it shows you a pie chart of the three different sentiments, positive, negative, and neutral. For most searches, you'll get a lot of neutral comments, which is natural, but here you'll have more positive comments than negative, 206 versus 41, which I think is good. On the right, it also lists some example comments classified as positive, neutral, and negative. Let's search a different one. Hashtag holidays. Not surprisingly, you find a ton more positive comments about the holidays. In this case, if you look at the example, even the negative ones are lighthearted. So there you have it. A demo of Twitter sentiment analysis using MetaMind. Even recurrent nets have found uses in character-level text processing and document classification. Deep nets are now beginning to thrive in the medical field. A Stanford team used deep learning to identify over 6,000 factors that help predict the chances of a cancer patient surviving. Researchers from IDSIA in Switzerland created a deep net model to identify invasive breast cancer cells. Beyond this, deep nets are even used for drug discovery. In 2012, Merck hosted the Molecular Activity Challenge on Kaggle in order to predict the biological activities of different drug molecules based solely on chemical structure. As a brief mention, this challenge was won by George Dahl of the University of Toronto, who led a team by the name of GGGG. But one crucial application of deep nets is radiology. Convolutional nets can help detect anomalies like tumors and cancers through the use of data from MRI, fMRI, EKG, and CT scans. In the field of finance, deep nets can help make, buy, and sell predictions based on market data streams, portfolio allocations, and risk profiles. Depending on how they're trained, they're useful for both short-term trading and long-term investing. In digital advertising, deep nets are used to segment users by purchase history in order to offer relevant and personalized ads in real time. Based on historical ad price data and other factors, deep nets can learn to optimally bid for ad space on a given web page. In fraud detection, deep nets use multiple data sources to flag a transaction as fraudulent in real time. They can also determine which products and markets are typically the most susceptible to fraud. In marketing and sales, deep nets are used to gather and analyze customer information in order to determine the best upselling strategies. In agriculture, deep nets use satellite feeds and sensor data to identify problematic environmental conditions. Which of these deep learning applications appeals to you the most? Please comment and share your thoughts. In the next video, we'll take a look at the main ideas behind a deep learning platform.